I just saw the documentary Citizenfour about Edward Snowden, which is a real-life thriller. It takes you from the moment that Snowden reaches out to journalists with NSA documents to now. Snowden risked everything to tell the world about what the NSA was doing, and yet he says that his greatest fear was that nothing would change. And even though Obama has talked about reining in the NSA and there are ongoing lawsuits against the NSA, so far that fear has come true.
My name is Edward Snowden. I go by Ed.
And for me, one of the craziest things about the film is to see how quickly the US government moves in on Snowden and the journalists who are trying to tell his story, which basically proves Snowden's point. US surveillance is global and total, but it's not the first of its kind, and it's worth it to look at how other governments have also heavily spied on their own people. Take, for example, East Germany. In the 50s, 60s, 70s, and 80s, they had a secret police called the Stasi. There was one Stasi informant for every 63 people. They tapped phones, put cameras in people's apartments, sprayed their floors with radiation so they could track their every footstep. They even trained dogs to sniff people out based on their stolen, dirty underwear. When Stasi files were finally released, one of the first people to read their own file was a guy named Roland Jahn, who discovered that his friends were informing on him and that his 8-year-old daughter was followed to school. It all seems ridiculous now because the key to tracking anyone so closely is right in their pockets. You've got a camera, a microphone, all your personal data, you even have a GPS locator. But why would anyone want all that information? Well, the Nazis, for example, would have loved it. According to a history professor that I spoke with, the Nazis were interested in spying on the German people to get their, quote, attitudes and moods so they could gauge their own popularity. It was way harder back then to get location data, and yet the Nazis had 2 million index cards full of people's names and addresses, mostly of gay people, Polish workers, gypsies, and of course, Jews, so that when the time came, they could easily find them and arrest them. They also tracked people's mail, just like the NSA, both paper and now electronic. Except the difference, of course, is quantity. Every day, the NSA collects 1.7 billion pieces of electronic communications, and every second, it adds terabytes and terabytes of metadata to giant information storehouses that it has around the world. The Stasi could only tap 40 phones at any given time. So yeah, while we're not living in East Germany, we probably have less privacy than any other generation ever has. And it's amazing how easily that information can be used against you at the drop of a hat as soon as the state decides, for whatever reason, that you are a threat. And those index cards last forever, and they can be searched retroactively. But doesn't the Constitution protect Americans? Well, you would think, except we've also got our friend the Patriot Act that has challenged the Fourth Amendment, which is your right not to have your goods or your stuff searched or taken without a warrant. Not to mention, the idea that you're being spied on or could be spied on might change what you talk about, who you talk about it with, what you read, where you hang out, who you hang out with. Basically, your First Amendment rights. The other thing we've learned from history is that people living in surveillance states often accept the fact that they're being spied on. But given what we know now, should we?